answer your questions about COVID-19 is Dr. Robert Murphy, is a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning.
Perhaps you saw these stories out of South Korea where it seems the virus is reemerging in people, or they're getting it again, or maybe the test is bad. I don't know. What's your insight? I would imagine this is a pretty big deal.
This is not that big a deal.
Okay.
They're expecting this. As restrictions everywhere loosen, and as people start moving around more or just feel more comfortable, you're bound to see this. I think what will happen in South Korea is they've got the whole testing, tracking, and treating thing down very well, and I think they'll be able to put it out.
But is this reemerging in the same patients who already had it, though?
That's a different question. We don't really know if those people have relapsed, if they really have the same virus again, the virus that they had originally, or if they really have a new virus. That will take some molecular testing. Mm.
Well, that's what's worrisome when we hear about, you know, this plasma testing where you take the plasma from people who have recovered and you put it in people that are sick. So if those people might get it again, how does that work if you're not immune to it?
Well, you know, some people who get exposed, particularly if they had a milder infection, perhaps, and I don't know, I'm just guessing, they didn't mount a big enough antibody response. Whereas somebody who was sicker really had a more immunologic response. That could be. I don't know. We'll see. Those cases really have to be investigated. It would be. I really don't think that this antibody thing. I think the antibody thing is good, and I think it's protective. Otherwise, we would have tons of reinfections.
All right.
And if we have a handful, okay. But we don't have thousands and thousands.
Okay. Let's take a look at our viewer questions. I have heard so much about hydrochloroquine, and there are other drugs being tested, or are there other drugs being tested? Is there anything that seems to be working?
There's a lot of drugs being tested. There's over 80 drugs being tested, and 84 vaccines are in development. There's a lot going on. Hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine are old malaria drugs that have been around for a long time. There is some laboratory evidence that maybe they are effective. However, there's no clinical evidence at all that they work. Most likely, if it does anything, it's really very small. There's no confirmed data that those drugs work. Those drugs do have toxicities. People have died from those drugs. A recent study comparing the drug against placebo, which is the way we like to do things, they actually had to stop one of the treatment arms with the hydroxychloroquine because so many people got sick and more people died. Mm. Forget that drug.
All right. Another question. Suggestions for parents of newborns when you bring them home. What if in-laws want to visit? Do you allow them? Do you make people wear masks? Can they hold the baby, et cetera? I haven't seen any reports on CDC recommendations.
Depends how much you like your in-laws. No, a couple things here. An important question. I don't mean to belittle it. The babies actually do very well with COVID if they happen to get sick. Very few complications in children, but some of them do get sick, so you don't want them getting it if they don't have to have it. You really don't want people from the outside coming into your environment, especially in the first month after you have a baby, when the babies are infants. After that, and probably restrictions will be lifted a little bit and people can socialize a little more, use common sense. The parents can wear a mask. The kid can't focus eyes anyway at that age. They don't know what they're seeing. And so, you know, you can gradually get into it. But right now, you don't want them in there.
When does Dr. Murphy think the supply chain of essential items like masks, bleach, hand sanitizer, cleaning products, and gloves will be available again? Everyone keeps giving advice on what to do, but doesn't help if you can't buy the products.
This is a really good question. Here we are, 3 months into this thing. We can't even have enough masks, gloves. They have the test kits now. They don't even have enough swabs to do the tests. This is basically a national and international disgrace why we can't do this. This is not difficult.
Well, we'll see what happens. One thing before we let you go, Mayor Lightfoot had said she thinks that the stay-at-home order is going to extend into May. What are your thoughts? What are your expertise on how long this is going to last?
Well, we're at the top of the peak right now. Most likely it's leveling off a little bit and it's going to come down, but it takes as long going down as it did going up. So if we're at the peak now, we're in the middle of April, you know, you're talking about the end of May, beginning of June, some of the predictions, even the middle of June.
Oh, brother.
All right. Well, Dr. Murphy, thank you.
We appreciate your feedback. It's not always good news, but
we're peaking and it's getting look at California.
Yeah.
Look at California and Washington. They're doing great. Look at Singapore. Look at these other places. It's going to happen and it's going to be maybe a bumpy start. You're going to have to have some restrictions, but it is going to let up and it is going to go away.
All right. Dr. Murphy, thanks again. If you have any questions for Dr. Murphy, he'll be here again at this time. Same time tomorrow. You can go to our Morning News Facebook page and post your questions there. Thank you.